So this beer festival that Russell Fruits from Grimm Brothers and Chris from Rackhouse are putting together for us is the perfect example of the Colorado craft beer community. Russell heard about the BS trademark lawsuit that we were dealing with and just took it upon himself to put this together for us, to help us out. I get a little choked up sometimes just thinking about the fact that somebody would just take it upon themselves to help us out this way. I'm Tim Myers, the head brewer from Strange Brewing Company. We're here in Denver, Colorado. We've been open now almost 3 years. We opened in May 2010, brewing on my homebrew setup, my one barrel homebrew setup. And our first year we brewed 100 barrels one at a time. Our second year, from January through August, we brewed 175 barrels one at a time until we got our 10 barrel setup, our current setup. We try and present ourselves as home brewers, sharing our beers with friends. We looked at doing something smaller that we could afford. And we didn't. It was right in the middle of the Great Recession. There was no way we were going to get a business loan. And, you know, 3+ years later, it's going great. The cool part about the Colorado craft beer community, I found out early on how amazingly generous the brewers and the breweries were. You know, I'm walking around total novice. I mean, I'm a home brewer, 5-10 gallons at a time. I'm going into these breweries and talking to these guys about opening my own place. And they were so excited for me. Sometimes it felt like they were more excited than I was. And they were always so generous with their answers to all of my questions. I always felt like I was trying not to bother these guys, and they're always so helpful. This year we're replacing all our old 7-barrel fermenters with brand new 10-barrel conicals, which is very exciting. It's the same amount of labor to brew 7 barrels as brew 10 barrels, so we might as well get those extra 6 kegs from the same batch.
Breweries, restaurants, you know, distributors, we're kind of all in a partnership together, and so the whole community aspect of craft beer, you know, makes me want to give back and help the people who helped me make my business successful. And, you know, coming from the craft beer side of it myself, you know, I know many of the business battles that people have, and how important it is to kind of help the greater good of the craft beer community.
It's the perfect example of Colorado craft beer drinkers and brewers helping each other out, you know, taking care of one of their own. And the only stupid part about it is that it's even necessary to begin with. I mean, some homebrew shop in Massachusetts named Strange Brew Beer and Wine is worried about Strange Brewing Company becoming a threat to them because of the success we've had selling pints across the bar.